as one of the few surviving members of the submarine band of the early Flying Burrito Brothers. Yes, how did I do it? I managed to stay alive. I must have been doing something right. And right now I'm going to do a song that was one of the first country songs that the submarine band recorded in 1966. Because in those days, everybody wanted to go out to California. And we went, but when we got out there in 67, it was all like pretty trippy, baby. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And people were into palm reading, astral diving, oral projection, oral readings. That was what was going on. And I had a friend, and he went for that whole hog. He studied it. He meditated. He practiced. And he honed his spiritual self into such a high plane that he turned into nothing but a pure beam of light. 1,000% pure. Now, the only opportunities available to him were pretty limited, and one of them was acting as the fog-like spotlight on an 18-wheeler that kept crossing the U.S., delivering freight from one side. They would load up in Long Beach. They would cross the Rockies, down through the plains of Colorado and Kansas, over the river and over that bridge in Memphis, back through the other mountains, the Appalachian Mountains, to go to Baltimore, where they'd unload, and then they'd pick up a shipment of pig iron and head back the other way, down through Virginia and Kentucky, again right across the Mississippi. At one time, they were out near Amarillo, and the truck driver was feeling mighty tired and mighty thirsty. And up ahead he saw a sign: all night coffee, donuts, 24 hours a day. Well, I stopped at a roadhouse in Texas, a little place they call Hamburger Dance. Inside the jukebox was playing a song about a truck driving man. Pour me another cup of coffee. It is the best in the land. I'll put a nickel in the jukebox. Play the truck driver name. Well, the waitress, she brought me some coffee. I thanked her and called her again. I said, that song sure has skipped me. I'm a truck driver, man. Well, pour me another cup of coffee. It is the best in the land. I'll put a nickel in the jukebox. Play the truck driver, man.
Sing with me, sing with me.
Pour me another cup of coffee. It is the best in the land.
As you can tell by the lyrics of the song, that guy loved his coffee. He didn't want none of that decaf, I'll tell you. And he kept going, I'll take a refill, I'll take a refill. He got his cup filled up again and again and again and again. Well, when he left that all-night diner, that guy was so wired. All that caffeine just pulsating through his system. And he walked out of the door into the parking lot, and there he saw that truck. And suddenly his whole mind changed. He had been chained to that truck, paying off his mortgage for all of these years.
and he could not face climbing into that cab ever again. He said, I hate this. I hate this. I never want to do this ever again. I can't stand it. And he started taking out all of his bad hate and energy on that truck. And he wailed back. And he wailed back again with his foot. The light was broken, and there on an oil-stained parking lot outside of Amarillo was my friend with all of his purification beam of light shit. My dear, oh dear, oh dear. And maybe this is just a lesson. Sometimes it's not best to aim for the sky. Sometimes it's best to keep your feet right on the ground. We'll pour me another cup of coffee. It is the best in the land. I'll put a nickel in the pot. Way the truck driving, man, let's do it again. Pour me another cup of coffee. Ford is the best in the land. I'll put a nickel in the jukebox. Play the truck driving band. And play the truck driving band. One more. And play the truck driving band. There you go. Nothing would be complete. Yeah.